everybody. Happy Monday. Hope everybody had a great weekend. Breaking news out of China. The list has been leaked, which has information which U.S. companies will end up being blacklisted in China. The list is not substantiated, but it was leaked to the Russian media this morning. As everybody aware, U.S. and China have had tumultuous relationship and been playing ping pong in pertaining to tariffs and also gearing up for the full-fledged economic war. In 2019, U.S. President Donald Trump announced that Chinese telecommunications giant Huawei is going to be banned from working with U.S. suppliers. Even though Huawei still posted $12 billion profit last year, their growth has been stunted because U.S. is a giant market and also there's been issues with Huawei in Europe as well. The reason for that, it is a threat to national security of the Western world. China uses this technology to spy, gather information on people, steal classified technologies. Since China itself barely creates anything that's proprietary or unique, it's always based on somebody else's platforms that were obtained not through legal means, and also violates patents and any type of international laws. Nevertheless, the list has been made, and it is important to point out what the ramifications will be. The list was originally announced by Ministry of Commerce in China last year, but it has not been implemented until this year. Well, actually, this is a leaked information. There was no public announcement from Chinese government which companies are on that list. But it was a reciprocal done immediately due to Huawei, and also because one of the key players of the Huawei was arrested in Canada on request of US, and she's been on house arrest since last year, awaiting extradition to US to face charges. She's accused of circumventing sanctions and selling to Iran. And everybody knows Iran is a severe threat due to possibility of nuclear weapons, and especially since Trump scrapped the deal Obama has made with Iran. So let's get back to China. All over the weekend, there's also been a ban of WeChat in US. And TikTok, US division is being sold to Oracle. It just has been approved. In that case, though, TikTok China said they're not selling the algorithm, but just the platform. So in that case, Oracle would have to develop their own algorithms. WeChat is one of the biggest social platforms in China, which integrates payment system, government services, news, social network, booking restaurants, ordering. So it's one app for almost everything. And the reason behind it, because majority of US apps are banned in China because China has great firewall of China, which censors everything. This is why everything is on Chinese websites and also Chinese developed, but it also allows the Chinese government to monitor everybody, gives them a social credit number, monitor everything Chinese people do and surveil them and possibly even arrest them if they don't comply, issue sanctions, fines. They could also even be banned from travel, international travel, etc. So basically, and this platform got banned since yesterday. So what US companies are on the leaked list? As it stands, there's Dell, HP, Cisco, Lockheed Martin, and Rockwell Collins. These are the companies. I should point out that this is not an official announcement from Chinese government. It was leaked to Russian media. It seems to be credible, but at the same time, again, as any leaked document, unless it's fully substantiated, at this point, this is news, but it's not 100%. Also, it is highly likely to expect not all of them will immediately be put on the list. It will be gradual based how much US puts Chinese companies are on the list. That's how many China will do. So more than likely, the first one will be either HP or Cisco, followed by Rockwell Collins and Lockheed Martin. The reason behind it is Rockwell has a lot of defense, same as Lockheed Martin. They're known as defense companies. They do have civilian segments. Rockwell has a lot of robotics, and they also do a lot of others, which could possibly hinder certain profits. But nevertheless, what does everybody think would be the response after this happens and the rest of the list in China? Also, would be interested to know if there should be complete cutoff. China and US should completely disengage and move all manufacturing like Japan did out of China gradually, even give subsidies to make sure the companies can move their manufacturing to Vietnam, India, and other nations, or possibly even have higher output on the domestic market and have domestic manufacturer reestablished in US on the West period. So I would love to hear everybody's opinions. Please click like, subscribe to my channel. You can also read my articles at www.communalnews.com under Christina Kitova. And hope everybody has a great Monday. Thanks again.